this morning is the plastic surgeon who stars in the TV hit Botched, and he joined us recently to talk about his reconstruction work. But this time we thought we'd get his advice on looking good at any age. Please welcome back Dr. Paul Nassif.
Nice to be here again.
Thank you so much for joining us. Now, people seek plastic surgeries and procedures at different stages in their life. What age do you think you should start looking at getting some help?
You know, it's interesting. We just had this discussion about a week ago with about 10 doctors. And starting in their 20s, and one thing that doesn't happen is the millennials.
Yep.
You know, the millennials should start just actually with good skincare, protection, hydration.
Ah.
And that's why, for example, a bunch of the products that we have at TVSN is on hydration. A little bit of anti-aging material in the 20s, but you want a protection and you want to hydrate early. Start in the 20s.
Mm. As you say, doctor, you've got your great skincare range, so that's a good place to start. But what about when we talk about more invasive types of surgery? I'm in my 40s, I have Botox. Should I be doing more?
All right, so what's happening now, in the next maybe 10 years, a lot of the stuff I do, less for facelifts and eyes, might not be done anymore. We're going to be more non-invasive material, radio frequency. So, for example, there's two different ways to look at it. Surgical, which is still the typical little mini lift, facelifts, eyes, cheeks, brows. And that's something that would probably always be there, but not as much with the more of the new technology. But secondly, with now the radio frequencies and other different devices, and still the uses of Botox and fillers and good skincare, and you are going to start wanting to doing these things in 30s and 40s. Tightening. Tighten up the collagen. So you can start there immediately in the 30s and go up. And then maybe instead of the 40s usually having something done surgically, maybe you can pop that to the 50s.
Ah.
Maybe.
So you get things done differently in your 30s compared to your 20s. Is that right?
Absolutely.
Okay, so you think tightening in your 30s.
Well, I mean, in the 30s, you want to start. Remember, here's how you get wrinkles. Let's say the forehead or here, because you're smiling all the time, you're elevating your eyebrows. So if we start weakening those muscles a little bit, with a little bit of Botox in the 30s, just a little bit, especially the 11s, then you're going to need that less. So you want to start at the 30s, you want to start some of the skin tightening procedures. Like, I use something called thermi, and that's radio frequency heat, or there's ultrasound. You know, a little tightening, tightening. And by the way, there are, you can use that for the entire body.
Really?
Oh.
So you can get a tight
one.
You can get a tight bottom.
You can actually get a tight bottom without procedures.
Oh.
Now, what about women in their 40s? That's not me. I'm just talking about you.
So, again, like, for example, we have a... There's a... few celebrities that came in 3 weeks ago to my office, and they go, I want something now for next week. Now, and they don't want fillers, they don't want Botox, so that's why then we wanted to get some of these tightening procedures, which usually take 3-4 months before they really show because they're not that invasive. But one of the things you can do now to really make your skin look good is microneedling. You know what microneedling is?
No.
Microneedling, and you can start this actually in the 30s. Yeah. It's a small handheld device with a little bit of needles, and they go in and out of the skin at different layers, and we use platelet-rich plasma, PRP, products of your own blood, and we do that, and it stimulates and gives you, helps with discoloration, fine wrinkles, not really tone, but gives you a better glow.
Really?
Does it hurt, though?
Well, of course it does. You have to put the numbing cream on for a while. Then we have different lasers for brown and red, all types of different things.
What about my scraggy neck?
Niecy's been worried about her neck, but I think it's beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
So not invasively for these muscles. A little bit of Botox will give a little bit of softening. But the real way to go, it's time for a little bit of a lift.
I got to ask you.
We got to do the little lift like this. A little vertical lift.
Yeah. I got to ask you about women over in their 50s, but I'm in my 70s, right? I had procedures years ago. In your 70s, it's just a case of waiting for the lid to come down.
No. It's not, I'm telling you. So, I mean, obviously now, I mean, back then, especially, you know, I'm in Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
And now people are coming the last decade earlier. But back then, plastic surgery was from 50s on up. So you still can, if you miss the boat, per se, you can still do, I mean, basically, the biggest thing is going to be a lift.
Yeah.
And we still do a lot of, you know, facelifts. But again, you want to make sure the incisions are beautiful. Hidden. And you got to always use skincare. All ages skincare together with a procedure.
We tried yours, and I thought it was great.
You know, I mean, by the way, we have, we brought in a bunch of gifts for everybody.
Oh!
I think actually, for the audience. stars as well.
Wow. Yeah, that the skincare treatment. And just in regards to the surgery, do you actually ever, are you ever in a situation where somebody comes in and you say, no, I'm not going to do that? No.
Well, that happens. If you watch my show, you'll see that all the time.
Yeah.
And then in my office, that happens about 10% of the time.
Okay.
Either there's not candidates for it or they're maybe psychologically not ready for it or they're unrealistic or they have body dysmorphia or they're plastic surgery addicts. So the answer is yes.
You guys really gonna love the show.
And you know, I mean, what I do, and this will happen for the rest of my career, you can't do non-surgical fixes. It's surgery of the nose.
Yes.
And so I'm internationally famous for these rhinoplasties and fixing them, and that will always be there.
And if you want to check out Dr. Paul Nassif's skincare range, you can buy it, as he mentioned, on TVSN. But today, because we love you, studio audience, you are all going home with Dr. Nassif's facelift peel-off mask. Dr. Paul, thank you so much for joining us.
Great.
Enjoy your time in our beautiful country.
And by the way, with this one, and you will have niacinamide, the niacin, which will flush you, so you might be red for about half an hour after. It's normal.
Oh, right, okay. Okay, good. There you go.
Love being here.